Today in this video, we're gonna convert this seat into this. Welcome back to the video. So hope you all are doing good, and unfortunately I'm really sorry I can't make the face cam videos due to my personal issues, you know. So hope you all can manage with it. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you Randall Hook and a perfect reset. Well, if you're all interested in this mod, then please make sure to watch this video till end. And the gameplay you're seeing right now is 100% real and it's not fake. So do you want to know how to install and how to use this graphics mod? Please make sure to watch this video till end. So first of all, let's talk about the system requirements in order to play this mod. Well, you need at least 4GB RAM, any quad-core processor, and 2GB of dedicated graphics card. I'll suggest you to play on GT 1030. If you have this type of card, then you can actually play this graphics mod very smoothly on your PC. Well, let's talk about the recommended specs in order to play this mod. Well, I tested this mod on 1050 Ti and the performance were really awesome. I was getting around 100 FPS. Oh my god, this is really awesome, you know. Now, if you install the similar ENB in your Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, then barely you will get 30 FPS, you know. So, if you have played the DirectX 2.0 on your high-end PC or medium specs PC, then you know the performance really decreases when you install an ENB series. But today in this video, I'm gonna say with the render hook reset, you know, that doesn't success FPS, you know. So if you all are interested in this mod, then please make sure to watch this video till end. So I'm gonna give shout out to my guy Fanatics, who commented on my yesterday's video. So thank you so much Fanatics for commenting. So if you want shout out from me, then hit that subscribe button and leave a like on this video. Also, don't forget to write something on comment so that I pick your comment in the next video, you know. So yeah. Without wasting any more time, let's get started with the video, guys. So my friend, as you can see, we are in our desktop screen, and first thing you need to do is download these three files from the given link in the description. So first of all, extract your render hook into your desktop or any specific folder you want to extract. Now once the file has been extracted, open your extracted file and then open your game directory, my friend. And the installation is very easy, only if you watch this video till end. So once the game directory has been opened, open your copy to the game folder and then just drag and drop all these files into your game directory and then hit on the play save task. Now minimize or close both of this window and then run your reset setup. But before you run your reset setup, please make sure your PC is connected to the internet, you know. Now from here, what you need to do is click on select your game and then open your game directory and then select your gta-asset.exe and click on open. Now from here, what you need to do is you have to select the DirectX 10 or 11. Now if your card doesn't support the DirectX 10 or 11, then I'm really sorry about that, bro. You can't play this graphics mode, you know. Or you can still try with your DirectX 9, you know. Now simply it will download some files. So let's wait till it completes our file. So guys, as you can see, our reset setup has been completed. Now open your game directory again and then just drag and drop preset.ini into your game directory. And then run your enb.exe or gta-sandias.exe and then your game will 100% start. Now as you can see, we have been redirected to our main menu. Run your new game or load game and then your game will 100% start. So let's wait a second, you know. Okay, just hold on. Okay, let me press some. Okay, so as you can see, we are in our game and our game looks not awesome. I'm really sorry about that. Now from here, what you need to do is press Shift plus F2 or home from a keyboard and then click on this little triangle and then select my abhinavpreset.ini, and then you can actually enjoy this graphics mode. So our graphics looks too awesome, isn't it? So that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching till end. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, then please make sure to leave a like on this video. Share this video to as much you can. And if you're new, then what are you doing? Please make sure to hit the subscribe button. So yeah, as always, I'll see you into my next one. Till then, goodbye. And one more thing. If you press 7 from your keyboard, but make sure your number lock has been enabled, then you can actually toggle between the depth of field effect into your in-game, and this will not cost your frames, you know. Now if you want some effect like depth of field in your game, then you can actually enable by pressing 7 from your keyboard.